Phase-based families are really useful because, well, as the name would suggest, they can be hosted on any face in the model. This makes them far superior to any wall-based, floor-based, ceiling-based, and similar families. A great example where phase-based families are really useful is in situations where we want to host a light on a ceiling, but we don't want to model the ceiling. We just want to use the bottom of the floor as a ceiling. See how here I can host a ceiling-based light to a ceiling, but here where our ceiling is just the bottom of the floor, it doesn't work. But if I use a phase-based light, it's going to work in both cases and even on this roof or a curved wall that I have. In this video, I will be showing you how to create a phase-based family, how to place it, how to create a phase-based light family, and even how to create a phase-based family that uses a void that's going to cut into the host. This is really useful in situations where we have recessed lights and where we need to actually cut into the ceiling to place our family. Let's go. The first step is the most important one. If you make a mistake here, you cannot change it later. So you go here to File, you go to New, and then to Family. Here you want to pick out the generic phase-based family template. Now, if you by mistake select the wrong one, like ceiling-based, and then hit open, what you'll notice is that here in the family category and parameters, under family parameters, the host is set to ceiling and it's grayed out. We cannot change it. So you really want to be careful. Now let's exit out of this one and go again to File, New, and pick Family. And here I'm going to search for generic model phase-based. Now you may be thinking, well, I want this to be phase-based. However, I don't want the category to be generic. I want the category to be furniture, for example. Well, that's okay, you can change that later. So let's pick out this one, hit open, and then in the family category and parameters, you will see that here instead of generic models, I can set this to furniture and it's fine, but it's important that the family parameter is set, or the family parameter host is set to face, and that's here and we cannot change it. Now let's click OK, and just to keep things simple, let's create a simple extrusion here in the center, just like that. Hit finish, let's go and save this family. I'm going to call this one test 1 and hit save, and now we can load this into the project and close it. Now what you'll notice is we can host this pretty much on any face we like. So it can go on a wall, it can go on a roof, on a floor, on this wall, even here on this 3D text, I can host that family there. So this is how you create a simple phase-based family in Revit. Now let's do something a bit more complicated. So I want to create a light family that's also phase-based. But if I go here to File, New, and then pick Family, you will see that within the family templates, under lighting, we don't really have phase-based light. We have ceiling-based, we have wall-based, but we don't have phase-based. Now, we need to use the lighting family template because lighting family templates have a lighting source that's really important for the families. So how do we get around this problem? Well, what we're going to do is we're going to create just a simple generic lighting fixture, and then we're going to nest that into a generic phase-based family. It might sound complicated, but trust me, it isn't. So I'm just going to pick this one and then hit open. Here you will see that we have a light, and if I open up the elevation, let's go to front, you'll see we simply have a light source here. Now for this light source, I want to change it and make it a face spotlight, hit apply, okay, and then let's go here to family types, and in the family types, I'm going to change the photometric web to something that works a bit better. Let's go with this lamp, hit open, and then let's set the tilt angle to 90 degrees, hit apply, okay. There we go. Now we have this issue where it's pointing down. Now I actually wanted to point up because for our face-based family, it's going to be down here. And then as you place it on a face, it's going to point in whatever direction is perpendicular to that face. So to spin this around, let's go back to family types. And here instead of 90, let's use minus 90, hit apply. Okay. and now it's perfect. Then let's go back to the reference level and create just some simple extrusion geometry to act in as a light, just like this. Hit finish. Go back to front and make it a bit smaller like that, and then let's drag this down so it's just on top of that geometry. Perfect. Once we have this, we can finally save it. So I'm just going to name this generic light family and hit save. Once this is done, we go again to file, to new family. And here we want to pick out the generic phase-based family and hit open. For this family, we're going to change the family category or from generic to lighting. Let's go with lighting fixtures, click OK. And now let's go back to our lighting family, go to load into project and close, and then load it into our family 6. This is the new family that we have created. Click OK. Now it's loaded here and I can just place it in the center. I can even go to the 3D view and see what this would look like. So this is the face where that's going to be hosted, and this is the actual family itself. Perfect. Now we just need to save this, so let's save this family, and this one I'm going to call phase-based light. Hit save, and now let's load this one into the project and close it. And here I can come and pretty much place it on any surface that they like, and this light is actually going to shine light when we want to render a night rendering with artificial lights. Finally, let's use the phase-based family template in order to cut into any phase that we like inside of the project. For that, let's go to File, New, Family. Here you want to pick generic phase-based, just like this, hit Open. And now we're going to use this generic extrusion that we have as a representation of our face to cut into with a void. So you want to go here to void forms, pick void extrusion, and then I'm just going to use a simple circular void extrusion, just like that. Hit finish, and let's open up this in the 3D view. Select this, and let's actually cut into this, just like that. Now here I want to go to cut geometry, select the representation of the face, and then click on our void. And now, as you can see, it's basically a hole. If I go to shaded, yeah. So we have like a circular void in our face. And now I can save this. Let's call it a void face-based family. Hit save, and then load it into the project and close. Here, you'll see that now I can basically cut holes or voids inside of any element in this project. Can I do it with this? Okay, so it's not working with 3D text, so it's not any element in the project, but with most elements it is going to cut. Here, because the ceiling is thin, it's actually cutting through and poking a hole in that ceiling. So there we go. We have created three different types of phase-based families in Revit. If you're serious about learning Revit, please check out the Balkan Architect website. It's available up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 150 hours of content on all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit.